दाम्बरधरं विष्णुं शशिवर्णं चतुर्भुजं प्रसन्नवदनं ध्याये सर्वविघ्नोपशान्तये। ॐ ब्रह्मानन्दं परमसुखदं केवलं ज्ञानमूर्तिं द्वन्द्वातीतं गगनसदृशं तत्त्वमस्यादिलक्ष्यम् एकं नित्यं विमलमचलं सर्वदि साक्षीभूतं भावातीतं त्रिगुणरहितं सद्गुरुं तं नमामि। ॐ सदाशिवसमारम्भां शङ्कराचार्यमध्यमां अस्मदाचार्यपर्यन्तां वन्दे गुरुपरम्परां शङ्करं शङ्कराचार्यं केशवं बादरायणं सूत्रभाष्यकृतौ वन्दे भगवन्तौ पुनः पुनः। ईश्वरो गुरुरात्मेति मूर्तिभेदविभागिने व्योमवद्व्याप्तदेहाय दक्षिणामूर्तये नमः।
It walks, after some time it halts. It looks back. It has got the habit. It looks back. Again it walks. Safety. Avalokana means seeing. Sivasya avalokana. See, this is a famous phrase in our language is Sivva avalokana. Like the looking back of a lion means either the author is looking back. Have I clarified the point? Or some other aspects are to be highlighted? He says, to make it further clear, let me put it in a different way now. Same thing. Vyapruteshu indriyeshu atma vyapari iva avivekina. Same thing is put in different way now. That is explained here in 22.
Ajnanan manaso padehe. Kartrutvadini chatmani.
Kartrutvadini chatmani.
Kalpyante mbhugate chandre.
Kalpyante mbhugate chandre.
Chalanadiyatham
bhasaha. Chalanadiyatham
bhasaha. Anvaya. Manasopadhehe. Ajnanat. Kartrutvadini cha atmani kalpyante yatha ambhasaha chalanadi ambhugate chandre.
Manasopade kartrutva adi. Kartrutva, doership, notion that I do, adi, bhoktrutva, I experience, I enjoy, I suffer. Kartrutva adi, so belongs to whom actually? To upadhi of mind. But what happens? Ajnana, due to aviveka, lack of discrimination between atma and anatma. Anatma is inner, it can't function. Atma is chaitanya sarupa, free from upadhi, it has no upadhi. So, but in the presence of atma chaitanya, anatma appears as though functioning. That is ajnana, because of atma anatma avivekina. Atmani kartrutvadini kalpyanti. Kartrutva, bhoktrutva, all these activities on the part of mind are what? Kalpyante. Kalpyante means superimposed, adhyasyante. It is, they are attributed to Atma. They are mistaken as if Atma is doing, Atma is enjoying, Atma is suffering, Atma is walking, Atma is talking. So then God says, I walk, I talk, all this we say, I enjoy, I suffer, all this is a kalpyante. For which an illustration is given. Yatha, just as chandre ambhasa chalanadi kalpyate. Kalpyate can be added. That is just as chandre, chandra is moon, in the moon. Ambhasaha, of the water, chalana adi, movements, etc. are what kalpyate superimposed. You know this illustration. What is the move is reflected in the water. Let us say some lake is there. and the moon is reflected, and the water of the lake is shaking. How the moon appears? Or it appears the torment, because shaking is too much, appears as though torment to peace. Or the lake water is very muddy. Heavy rain was there, so water has become very muddy. And you know which moon? Full moon. Bright and brilliant. It looks like what? Dust. Adi for the condition of the water. Now, movement belongs to whom? Water. Muddiness belongs to whom? Water. But you are superimposing one who? Suppose moon looks at that, what? The reflection in a muddy, shaky rain says, ayo, I have to take bath now. Does the moon take a bath? No. Or, ayo, I'm torn into pieces. It laments. It doesn't take it to be belonging to oneself. It doesn't belong to oneself. So there is a yatha amrasaha chalanadi. So chalanadi ambugateya chandre kalgata. Chandre, which chandra? Ambugata. You know what is literally ambugata means? One who has entered the water. Suppose moon enters the water, what will happen? And it should be sun. Sun enters the water. What has happened? Come on, tell me what has happened.
No, there will be no water. All the water is
evaporated. No, no. Before he enters, earth will not be there, we will not be there. Entry afterwards. So we will not be there at all. We will not be there at all. So that is ambhugati kalpanti. That is what falsely attributed superimposed. So therefore, due to Aviveka, no doubt it is accepted that Atma appears to do all this. Now come on, tell me, what is the outcome of all this? Atma is not the doer, not a karta. Atma is not bhokta. Atma doesn't do karma. What the outcome of it? It's a piece of information. Is it? So somebody told me, they go to foreign countries and they do some PhDs. I was once told, we are all information banks. we are all information, but it's of no use at all. And then go what? After all these things, go in some, they have to join some social organization, international, and go in Africa also. Africa also. It's an excellent quote by a person who was doing it. It is of no practical use. That is that. See, that is no. What is the outcome? I do. What is the outcome of it? Karan is punched. What Karan is punched? Karma pala. I, when you said, you did, look here. Law of karma is what? The doer has to reap the consequence of the karma phala, karma. Now, who does do it? You say, I. Come on, which I it is? How many eyes are there? Not chakshu, not UIEI. Me, as the individual, how many eyes are there? One day. Happy eye, sorrowful eye, angry eye, hungry eye. That is all attributed to eye. Eye is only one. See, if these are different eye, hungry eye will be one, eater eye will be another. And there is no connection between eating and appeasing the hunger. Not that way. Cannot be that. See, the if I, Atma, is the doer, he is responsible for the karma. The one who does should necessarily have the bhoga. Now you, come on, analyze this entity called I. Which is entity I? You refer 1,000 times a day. Which is entity I? You refer to the body as I. Agreed? Swamiji, so many years I exposed to Vedanta. I, Atma. What you know about Atma? Except the word? What you know about Atma? At the most you will tell what? It is a sentient principle, it is a pure awareness principle. What different does it mean? You are what you are. Had you known Atma directly, aparokshataha, you will not be anywhere around here. We will have to hunt for you somewhere lost in where? Samadhi, in your sarupa, paramananda, sarupa. That means Abba. In spite of teaching, we are what? Unscathed. No. See, this body superficially appears as what body does. But body is, you know. If you say, I, Atma does, Atma has no body. Nirupadi. Body cannot act, do karma. Atma cannot act, nirupadi. Body is inner. Yet there is one entity I do, yes or no, our experience tells or not. Who is that? One who is identified with the body, who is he called? Ahankara. Will come afterwards. Because this Ahankara it appears, and that entity is responsible for karma. Neither the Atma nor the body, but this erroneous entity, Ahankara. So therefore, if in the wake of knowledge of Atma Swarupa, me as free from all upadhis, so I know I am not the doer, I am not the karta, I am not the enjoyer, or I am not the sufferer, I am not the bhokta. Therefore, what happens? Karma phala and bhoga do not belong to me. Me, Atma, is not responsible for any karmas at the part of the upadhi. But it is not a borrowed statement from Shastra. It should be made on my aparoksha jnana, my aparoksha anubhava. I use this word jnana anubhava together because lot of misconception is there about it. If I know my true nature, do you mean to say there is no experience? When I suffer, do I experience or not? When I enjoy, I experience or not? When I think, I experience or not? When I see, I experience or not? All these are presented by what? Antakarna vrittis. And because of our ignorance, aviveka, all these features of antakarna vritti may be dependent on the external world, appear as though belonging to Ayatma. Means, when Atma is with the upadhi, of the antakarana vritti, that experience is possible on account of who? Is it on account of antakarana vrittis? No? Why not? Because of who? The basic principle, anubhava swarupa atma. But what do the antakarana vrittis do? They attribute the features of hunger, thirst, walking, talking, thinking, etc. Joy, sorrow, etc. to who? Accepted. Means all our experiences, the sample analysis I have given you, means all our experiences in the waking and the dream are on account of what? Antakarana vrittis. Made, brought to the level of experience by who? Not vrittis. Anubhava swarupa atma. The very self-experiencing principle atma. Means all our sopadhika experiences. Experiences with, what is that? Specific features are made to experience by who? Suppose all these specific features, antakarana vrittis, are removed. In short, in technical term, entire adhyasa is removed. What it means? Anubhava swarupa atma. Does that experience cease to be? If it ceases to be, what will happen, you know? Atma is anubhava swarupa. When vrittis are there, and when vrittis are not there, atma ceases to be. If atma ceases to be, what will happen? Anubhava swarupa atma ceases to be, what will happen? Jagadanta prasajjeta, stupor everywhere. Nothing is known, nothing is experienced. Means what should happen now? Atma with experiences, not experiences, with the vrittis, appears with the experience of those features. No vrittis, Atma is what? In its true nature, as a self-experiencing principle, in its true nature. Where does the experience go? All because of not knowing what is experience, what is knowledge. In knowledge, what happens? That experience has to be true to the entity that is known. See, look, an experience or knowledge can be true to the entity known or experienced. It can be either way. But for practical purpose, when we use the word experience and knowledge, we take it for granted what? It is in accordance with the entity that is known or experienced. Knowledge, I don't think, there is no hard and fast rule that knowledge is always correct. You mistook a seashell for a piece of silver. So long as you are perceiving a piece of silver, is it knowledge or delusion? Delusion! Because you are getting this at Vedantic talks. When you don't know that it is what? Shell and silver is not. But afterwards someone pointed out, no, look, it is what? Shell. Either to knowledge became what? Delusion. Yes, sir? Like that. Again, knowledge can be that. That's why Vedanta plays very safe. Because knowledge can be wrong, it uses a word prama, not simple jnana, prama. Prama means, we know what is that? Correct knowledge. There is no question of being incorrect. Prama is what? Correct knowledge. Other thing. Now, you know your swarupa atma or not? You know? When I said, now what I mean by now, come on, tell me. In the state of ignorance. In the state of ignorance, do you know the Atma Swarupa? Means you are not aware of your Swarupa, except it. Suppose the Vedantic teaching worked and you took industrious effort to develop jnana, not jnana, vairagya. You took industrious efforts to develop vairagya and antakarana became very shuddha. And in the shuddha antakarana, you could straight away know your swarupa. Then what? Earlier, I was not aware of Atma in its true nature. Now I am aware of Atma in its true nature. What you are aware of, come on, tell me. Is it experience or not?
Yes.
Then why this allergy about the word experience? What you are aware of, is it not experience? It may be correct, it may be wrong. But that we accept. If it is correct, also experience. If it is wrong, also is experience. So therefore, presently the state of ignorance, what we experience about ourselves, the samsari jiva, is wrong, incorrect. But then, so whatever, all these samsaric experiences which are presented, how they are presented? Antakarana vritti. So they are removed. You are what? You are aware of what you are. You are aware of what you are without you being there. You understood what it means? That pramata knower experiencer is not there. If that experience is there, foul. It is not Atmanubhava. It is not Brahmanubhava. See, better know this. So you should know that, be aware. Otherwise, whole life long, what? You know, last 50 years I am studying Vedanta. Like a student telling, last 10 years I am in the 9th standard. What greatness is that? What greatness is that? Greatness is that? So, of course, even teaching also. To suit to the taste. Once it happened, you know. The first two courses, long term courses at Koyambattur Ashram, Anaikatti, I used to go as a visiting acharya. That's why I'm talking to a brahmacharya something. I said, look, my teaching is not seller's market, it is not buyer's market, it is seller's market. I told. My teaching is what? Seller's market and not buyer's market. No. Either you want to go. Buyer's market is what? Play to the gallery. To cater to the venture. How long you are going to expose to this? Better know what it is. Better know what it is. If you know what it is, what will happen? You will try to develop those preparedness frame of mind which is indispensable. Other whole lifetime, yes, a goody, goody, goody thing. It's a good pastime, a morning we have seen. This is morning we have seen. Vedanta should not be a good hobby of pastime as such. It should be on war footing. Why war footing? Time is flying away. Once this human embodiment has slipped off from the hand, we don't know when the next human embodiment is going to come. And when that next embodiment has come, we don't know whether this facility is for. Kaliyuga master might have got advanced as such. We don't have this. You know, Ramakrishna Paramahansa, this is it. Every day, at the time of dusk, used to weep. Oh mother, one more day has gone. But I have not got your darshan. that anguish must be. That anguish must be. So that person said, so that is due to aviveka, due to ajnana. So what happens? Kartritva, bhoktritva, etc. appear as though the intrinsic features of Atma Swarupa, and we experience that is what is called as what? Samsara. When you strip them off by knowledge, knowing that they don't belong to this thing, and appreciate Atma in its true nature, free from all these things, you are what you are, Satchidananda Swarupa. You are what you are, Satchidananda Swarupa. So that is why they look in Bhagavad Gita, 18th chapter, Skanda 15th Bhashya, in Mridhanagosha. You know that reference better than me, okay. 1,000 times I have repeated it in now this edition. Mridhanaka Bhashya 1-4-10 famous Mahavakya, Aham Brahmasmi. Aham Brahmasmi. As they say there, to gain Atma Jnana, all that you have to do is Adhyasa Nirakarana, Adhyasa Nibarhana. Get rid of that Adhyasa. You know what, when you get rid of Adhyasa, all Adhyasa, come on, beginning from where? Avidya, ignorance of oneself, onward, entire jagat, how is it presented to you? Is it without antakarana vritti? Get rid of that, you know what you are? You are what you are. At one place, Vidyanand says, first, get rid of the extrovertedness, he calls as Bahir Drishti, and then develop what is called as Antar Drishti, that is introvertedness. Introvertedness means mind withdrawn from preoccupation in the external. You are what you are. Now you will understand why Vedanta repeats at the risk of your annoyance. What is that? Vairagya, vairagya, vairagya. Why it repeats vairagya, vairagya, vairagya? What can be done? Even one desire is there. That is what? You are already booking. What booking? Future, you know what happened? Satya Sai Baba was in his 20s or 30s. One old Swami who has crossed 75, had come to him. And he would know that his work already one leg is in the grave. This Swami, he was very disciplined and very meticulous, etc. And he has done sadhanas and advanced this thing. But Satya Sai Baba could find out he has got one desire. So what is the desire? Very noble desire. What is that? Vedodharana. Upliftment of the Vedas. Because they are all the not bad or good. Satya Sai Baba called. Look, don't worry about this. I have come for that. You go peacefully. Don't bother about that. Then what happens now? Ticket is booked there. Which ticket? Return ticket is booked there. That is why, see, a person who is totally self-centered, that total highness and minus with the body has to be removed. For which what is that? Share with others, be with others, sympathize with others, help others, give others, all this should be there. Help them, etc. But when you have advanced, even that sattvic desire becomes what? Obstruction. Sattvic desire becomes obstruction. someone tell me a relevant phrase from sadhana chatushtaya, not sadhana, sadhana panchaka. Someone tell me. Do you remember? This topic has come in sadhana, so this sadhana panchaka. Just we are taking up here. Jana krupa naishturyam usrujyata. Jana krupa naishturyam usrujyata. That is krupa, compassion, pity, etc. Yes, it is required. Then, now when you have come to the level of nidhindhyasana, it is what? Obstruction. Naishturya, being harsh to people, etc. Get it out there. Is that? That is how it is. So therefore, what sadhana at what level should be very, very clear. The earlier one, see, when you climb up, 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 do you get stuck up to the earlier the steps only? You leave them and go up, is it not? Like that, earlier what is useful or not, should not have been there. All this what, that is what is called as philanthropic activities, etc., are necessary to get rid of the self-centeredness. Once that is there, rise up. After you reach, if you can do it, well, then make it. But don't want to be under the impression that, oh, in the Rishikesh, there is a phrase, pahunch gaya. You have already reached. Reached kitha. Generally, the phrase is reached means Brahma Sakshatkara has taken place. But it is not an imaginary thing, it should be truly true. But not be under the impression that I have already reached that stages. That is how, so that being the case, so to gain knowledge, what is necessary? Freedom from all that is adhyastha. So that being the case, so it is true that by pratyaksha, direct experience, kartritva, doership, bhoktritva, enjoyership, suffering, all these we experience as our own feature, but really they belong to manasa upadhi, for which the movement, etc., of the moon in the water work is. Now the doubt can come like this. Sir, you are talking about kartritva, bhoktritva, doership, enjoyership, suffering, etc., belonging to whom? Mana. But like you, other people also are there. Who are they? Tarkika. They are also philosophers, highly intelligent. See, Nayayikas, Vaisheshikas, Tarkikas. Olden days, before study of Vedanta, the student was put on Nyaya, Nyaya Tarka, that branch of knowledge. You know why? To give an exercise to the mind of analyzing and all this. And if anyone enters into Vedanta without Nyaya, ayo, Anyaya Vedanta. This is it, Anyaya Vedanta. You just got 2 minutes. Anyaya means without Nyaya. Not justifiable Vedanta also. Means he is not justified in taking to Vedanta. But present day, no problem. Why? Because if present day education is not able to give you the bread, it can give you the body. It can give you a capacity to think, etc. It can do. Whatever it is. See? Do that. So, these tarkikas, nayayikas, they say, do you know what they say? That is, kartritva, bhoktritva, raga, iccha, vesha, sukha, dukkha. That is what? Is that? doership, likes, dislikes, desires, sorrows, all these belong to Atma, I, Chaitanya, and not to mind. You told all these belong to who? Mind. But they say it belongs to who? Atma. Where do you stand now? Whom I should follow now? You, Vedanti or Tarkika Nayayika? They seem to be forward, rational, logical. So, I think better follow them. Or you prove to us that raga, dvesha, sukha, dukkha, all these do not belong to who? Atma, but they belong to who? Buddhi, mind, antarkaran. Then we'll accept it. Right proposition or not? Practical. Practical. Let us see now what Vedanta has to say.
Rage cha sukha dukkhadi.
Rage cha sukha dukkhadi.
Buddhau satyam pravartate.
Buddhau satyam pravartate.
Sushuptau nasti tannashe.
Sushuptau nasti tannashe.
Tasmat buddhestu natmanaha.
Tasmat buddhestu natmanaha.
Anvaya as it is, ragaha, ichha, sukha, dukkha, adi, buddhau satyam pravartate, sushuptau na asti.
Sushuptau tannashe na asti.
Sushuptau tannashe na asti. Tasmat buddhehe tu.
Tasmat add te.
Buddhehe tu. No atmana.
Buddhehe add eva dharma. Buddhehe si. Sushuptau tan nasti. Tat nasti. Then, sushuptau tannashe nasti. Tasmat te buddhehe eva dharmaha tu atmanaha na. Tu atmanaha. A very great truth. Should know it for certain. Raga likes, ichha desire, sukha joy, dukkha sorrow, adi. Adi, what is that adi? Varieties of antakara vrittis giving us variegated types of experiences. In short, what we brand as what? Samsara. Experience of samsara. So Buddha, satyam pravartate. They are there so long as your buddhi antakarana is there. Yes or no? How will you prove? You have to find that this thing, two cases. When buddhi is there, these are there. Buddhi is not there, these are not there. Therefore, they belong to whom? Buddhi. What method it is called? Advaya vatireka. Advaya, continuance, presence. Vatireka, discontinuous absence. One is, other is. One is not, other is not. for continuous. For example, buddhi is, antakarana is, all these experiences are, even in dream also these experiences are. When you sleep, is antakarana available? Is buddhi available? Are these raga, ichha, sukha, dukkha, they are there? You can very easily verify what they belong to whom? Buddhi, antakarana. Not to the Anvaya-vyatirika method is a great blessing. All reasonings are based on Anvaya-vyatirika. You understood now, what? Continuous now see. In waking and dream, buddhi is there. Tell me, atma is there or not? In sleep, buddhi is not there. Tell me, atma is there or not?
Yes.
What happens? Atma has got anvaya in the waking, dream and sleep, whereas buddhi has got vyatireka, absence, discontinuance, where in the? You want to know more? Study first chapter of Panchadashi, Tattva Viveka, take my commentary. I am not canvassing, but I have explained it very thoroughly. Very thoroughly. See, there are certain portions of Tarka there. Especially, if I remember correctly, verse 50, 51, 52 actually. Terse logic is there. Actually, if you skip those three verses, you are not at all at loss. The topic is what? Continuing. But why Vidyarandana brought it there, unnecessary to give us difficulty? No, no. Those days, among his audience, Tarkikas also were there. And that was their doubt. And if he doesn't answer that doubt, what happens? He speaks Vedanta, but he doesn't know. Tarka, he has to answer it. He's a teacher. He's an acharya. So that's why he has to answer. Very tough. In fact, in my comment of it, even if you skip on. That first time when I visited the long-term course at Coimbatore, I don't know what was the reason I was given this chapter. And when this portion was done, that is four said, I think about 8 months of this thing or something was over. The in charge there told student, anybody wants return ticket? Consult us. One of the students said, Swamiji is so confident that he has come with a confirmed return air ticket. So that entire program will be what? As per planned earlier, nothing is that. So is there something which is a anvaya metric? At times we have to, because that is what is depends on the audience. Present day it is not that. It is that much, even in the first chapter of Panchadashi Tattva Viveka Prakarana, we need not. But Anvaya Vyatireka is necessary. But it helps us to know the or establish the facts and the truth. So that is Ragecha Sukha Dukkhadi Buddhau Satyam Pravartati. Buddhau Satyam. So long as buddhi is operating, antakkarana is operating, all these are there, they operate, they function. We experience all of them. Sushuptau, in the deep state, tannashe means tasyaha buddhihe nashe. When that buddhi is no more there, it is extinct for the time being merged in his in his immediate cause, ignorance. So tannashi, nasti, what are not there? Raga, Icha, Dvesha, Sukha, Dukha, and accepted? Yes or no? Oh, you have to verify.
Yes.
What does it mean? Tasmat. Te means what? Raga, Icha, Sukha, Dukha, all these likes, dislikes, joys, sorrows, etc. Te. Buddhehe eva dharmaha. Are the features of what? Buddhi only. Natu Atmana. Atma is free from. But presently, Atma appears nothing but these only. Why, what has happened? You are falsely attributed. That's why Viveka. So, see, look here, something. Vedanta or gaining Atma Jnana is not an overnight process. It needs a lot of preparation. So that you will say, yes, I am just saying, but what happens? But this entire samsara gushes in my mind. Come on, tell me how the samsara gushes in your mind. Somebody is pouring with a hose pipe. How it gushes? Elephant is going. Does it enter your mind? But it is there in your mind, that elephant. How did it enter? Antakarana? Samsara gushes in the mind through antakarana vritti. Where do these antakarana vrittis are there? In what things they are there? Of course, in the mind, that is true. But they are where you have got interest. Is it not? Where you have no interest, are these antakarana vrittis are there? Where you have interest, come on, tell me. Interest there what? Things, objects, beings and events for which you have a value. What value? They will give me happiness. They will make me contented. Is it not? If this evaluation on your part is not there, are you going to be interested in that? No force in the world can drag your mind to those things. So therefore, where we have to start? In the modern language, re-engineering of your value structure. modern good old thing only. Good old thing. People fall for some things. Re-engineering of a value structure. Do that. That is, reconsider your values. Right. Don't go by what you have taken for granted. Analyze. That is how that. You have to start from that. When you start, what will happen? What is beneficial, you will keep. Others, what will that? You will discard. Slowly, what happens? Gushing of samsara becomes what? Don't expect it to stop. It will continue. But it is there. The flux is reduced. That is what in Vedantic terminology this re-engineering is Viveka Vairagya. This is what? Viveka Vairagya. So if somebody says Viveka Vairagya, the old people, they don't know what it is about. Re-engineering. Oh yes. And they will keep seminar in what? 5-star hotels. Suited to your purse, okay? Oh, what a great speaker. What a great knowledge. Who can't be like that? Free. If you get free, check. So that is how it is. So that means the sleep proves that the likes, dislikes, desires, sorrows, joys, all these agitations, all these belong to buddhi antakarma. When sleep, when the antakarma is not there, none of is there. Therefore, they don't belong to atma. Now tell me, is this the tarkika right or wrong? Wrong. It's wrong. Superficially, yes, true. But that philosophy is wrong. Sir accepted what you are told. But tell me one thing, what is the nature of this atma? You say, this doesn't belong to that, this doesn't belong to that. Accept it. Tell me what exactly is this atma. Let us see.
Prakashorkasya toyasya
Prakashorkasya toyasya
Shaityam agneerya toshnata
Shaityam agneerya toshnata
Swabhava satchidananda
Swabhava satchidananda
Nitya nirmala tatmanaha
Nitya nirmala tatmanaha
Anvaya यथा प्रकाशः अर्कस्य स्वभावः शैत्यं तोयस्य एड स्वभावः उष्णता अग्नेः एड स्वभावः एड तथा सत चित आनंद नित्य निर्मलता आत्मनः एड स्वभावः स्ति प्रजाभ्यः परिपादयन्तां न्यायेन मार्गेण महीमहिषा वो ब्राह्मणेभ्यः शुभमस्तु नित्यं लोका समस्ता सुखिनो भवन्तु काले वर्षतु पर्जन्यः पृथिवी सस्य शालिनी देशो यं शोभरहितः ब्राह्मणा सन्तु निर्भया ओम सर्वे भवन्तु सुखिनः सर्वे सन्तु निरामया सर्वे भद्राणि पश्यन्तु मा कश्चित् दुःखभाग् भवेत् असतो मा सहितमय तमसो मा ज्योतिर्गमय मृत्योर्मा अमृतं गमय ॐ पूर्णमद पूर्णमिदं पूर्णात् पूर्णमुदच्यते पूर्णस्य पूर्णमादाय पूर्णमेवावशिष्यते ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः हरिः ॐ श्रीगुरुभ्यो नमः हरि ओम